coming up on High School Game Night, playoff edition. It's win or go home. Manheim Central Barons looking to stay unbeaten versus Waynesboro in the 5A bracket.
Also in 5A, Cocalico Eagles facing a familiar LL opponent. Cedar Crest, Battle of the Birds. Who got the victory? Find out next, because High School Game Night starts right now.
If you break down, break down, break down. Break
down. One, two, three.
Mouse, be a better, better.
You can't beat me.
You can't beat me.
Ball, beat me.
Distance touchdown.
Hello and welcome to the playoff edition of High School Game Night. Four games to show everyone tonight featuring LL teams. Of course, as always, I'm Chad Landers.
And I'm Brian Cast. We begin in the 5A bracket with a couple of teams that are no strangers to the postseason. Manheim Central and Cocalico. Now, Chad did a deep dive into the recent first round history for these squads.
Yeah, that's right. Really fascinating when you kind of look at it. Both these teams have done really well over the past 10 years in the District 3 playoffs and specifically in the first round. All right, let's start with Cocalico. As you can see, the results going back to 2007. We have all of them right here. Under Coach Gingrich, the Eagles have won just about every first round matchup with a 7-1 record. Couple of good ones in there, actually, if we take a look at it. Northeastern, the victory last year by 1 point right at the end of the game. A very good one, so we can see if Cocalico can add to it this season.
Yeah, you were there last year at Northeastern.
Let's head over to Manheim Central. We'll head back over to the Manheim Central roster as well and see how they did.
Also a storied history here in the first round. They made the District 3 playoffs 26 years in a row. Pretty incredible stuff. In the past decade, though, Central 8-2.
Right.
Couple of L's there. Redland and Palmyra in overtime.
Triple overtime.
And it does include, of course, three wins straight years over Garden Spot.
Oh, poor Garden
Spot. My poor Spartans.
Right. So let's go to 2017 now. There are some elimination games this week. You got to win to keep your season alive. Manheim Central, the 2 seed in the 5A bracket, taking on 7 seed Waynesboro.
Correct. Barons, of course, have yet to taste defeat. They're still unbeaten, hosting tonight's game over on the frozen tundra of Eldon Ratu Field. Game time temperatures in the 20s, but the Barons offense starts to heat up early. Sophomore Evan Simon, heck of a first half effort. In a scoreless game, finds Jake Novak, and just like that, they are down in the red zone. Couple plays later, Simon looking, finds Garrett Fittery here for the opening score, 7-0 Barons.
Right, so later in the first quarter, those two will connect again. Simon to a wide open Fittery. How do you lose him on a play like that? And he just kind of glides into the end zone, makes it a 14-0 game. Barons defense also came to play. Check out Tyler Simon here, gonna rise up. Oh, nice hop there, picks it off. Barons get the ball back, and they are in great field position.
Yeah, leads to this. Simon floats it out to Jake Novak again, spinning his way into the end zone, makes it a 21-point lead now.
All right, you got to see this play from Colin Erb. Receives the swing pass. Big fella going to show the speed. Yeah, look at him go. Blown by the Waynesboro defenders. And he's in there for the touchdown. One of Evan Simon's 5 first half touchdown passes. Garrett Fittery had 3 TDs, including that gem right there. Central cruising to victory. Final score was 55-0. It is the Barons' 53rd District 3 playoff win, and no surprise, Brian, that is a record.
Fantastic.
So, Barons are moving on to the semifinals. They will play the winner of our next game, 3-seed Cocalico versus 6-seed Cedar Crest.
I said it earlier, Battle of the Birds. Mm-hmm. These two met earlier this fall back in week 6. Cocalico won it 55-6, part of their 9-1 regular season record. But this has been a resurgent season for Cedar Crest. What would they bring tonight in the playoffs? Well, early, it's Noah Palm airing it out, finds Aiden Fry for the completion here. Chains are moving, and Cocalico will find themselves on the goal the line where Garrett Long and Ecker punching it in from 1 yard out. Eagles lead 7-0.
All right, defense also showing up for Cocalico. Check out this play. Ben Fromm forces the fumble right here. Brandon Brubaker picks up the loose ball, and he is rumbling the other way, usually bulldozing over people. But, yeah, he turns on the Jets here, and he will cross the goal line, but a penalty brings it back. So, very next play. Noah Pump keeps the ball here, and he will cut it outside. And, boy, he is flying down the sideline. Cedar Crest isn't going to catch him. That's a 58-yard touchdown for the sophomore quarterback. Eagles go up 14-0.
Couple of 1 yard brutozer touchdowns later, Eagles up 28-7, and Palm here airs it out again. Ronald Zahm gets it, scampers down the sideline, somehow stays in bounds. Another TD. The Eagles up big at the half. They go on to win it 42-7 in this rematch from week 6. Cocalico heading to the District 3 5A semifinals as well next Friday.
Yeah, it's a good win for them. Lots more to come here on High School Game Night. We will move to the 6A bracket where a couple of LL teams from Section 1 were in action. Could both Wilson and Manheim Township advance to those semifinals? Find out next. We'll be right back.
High School Game Night brought to you by JD's Pazzo Pizza in Ephrata.
All right, welcome back to High School Game Night. We're going to move on to the 6A bracket as promised. Manheim Township with a 9-1 record, earning a Section 1 championship.
Yeah.
Congrats to them. But still plenty of unfinished business in the playoffs. Brian, they've never won a District 3 title.
That's a good stat,
yeah,
Chad. Their opponents this week, 7-seed Central Dauphin, someone's alma mater. This, a rematch from week 1 of the regular season.
Yeah.
Blue Streaks did beat the Rams 17-14. Township, though, fired up again at home in Neffsville for this one, and they will get on the scoreboard first. QB Luke Engie, nice play fake, keeps it somehow squeezing through that defense there, Chad. It's an early 7-point lead for the Streaks.
Not the Rams of old. Same score, second quarter again. MG out wide to Brett Benjamin. Great play, and he does just get across the goal line. 14-0, Township leading. And they go find that sideline here because, yeah, they deserve it, working hard.
Absolutely. Streaks offense just keeps delivering. MG finds Grayson Saladay. He was injured earlier in the game. Looks like he's okay. Township's third touchdown of the game there. And the Blue Streaks, this is no contest. They blast Central Dauphin. Apologies. Landon, final score, 28-0.
Township's the better team this year, that's for sure.
I suppose. More from the 6A bracket. Defending District 3 champion Wilson making a late push this season. Moved up in the district rankings all the way to that number 3 spot.
Right at the end of the year there. All right, Bulldogs led on offense, of course, by senior Iggy Reynoso. We talk about him all the time. The all-time leading rusher in Berks County history. 4,600 yards combined between his times at Hamburg and Wilson. That's a little known fact there.
Yeah.
Deep playoff run could push him over the 5,000 marks.
We'll see there.
Let's go to West Long. Wilson players always need to rub the Bulldog for good luck, and it usually works out for him. First offensive play for Wilson after a blocked punt. There you have him, Iggy Reynoso, 28 yards to the house, gives Wilson a 7-0 lead.
Yeah, and then look at this, more punting trouble from Redline, deep in their own territory. Oh. Joey Fox blocks it. Chris Price gonna track it down. Gullet to Wilson, touchdown makes it 14-0.
Well executed there. Red Lion does put together a drive, 4th-and-1 here. QB Zach Brown dumps it to Elijah Workinger. Finds a lot of daylight here, all the way for a touchdown. It's a 14-7 game.
Yep, to the second quarter, Wilson QB counter, Eric making a play. Design keeper finds the outside. We'll dive in here to cap off a 24-yard scamper, 21-7 lead for Wilson.
All right, back to those punting woes for Redline. Trevor Hatley gets a paw on it here. Nick Johnson, he will scoop it up, and the Bulldogs are in business. Don't score there, but Abdul McFoy eventually going up the gut here, finds his way in for another red and white touchdown. Wilson rides their late season surge to another win, 42-7. It'll be Township versus Wilson next week in the semis. What a game.
Looking forward to it. Well, that is it for our highlights, but don't go anywhere. We will pass along all the other scores from the District 3 playoffs, all coming your way after the break. We'll be right back.
High School Game Night is brought to you by Yogurt Works Cafe in Ephrata, where you can build it your way.
And welcome back to the postgame show. Let's get you up to speed on all the other District 3 playoffs going on around the area tonight.
Good game.
In the 6A bracket, number 1 seed Cumberland Valley dominates in their District 3 opener over 8 seed Central Dauphin East. It is a 62-9 score. 4-5 matchup was a really good one here.
Yeah.
Heffield representing the LL League came down to the final play or so, but the Black Knights hold on for the 31-28 win over Dallas Town.
On to some of the other brackets in 5A. Governor Mifflin taking on York High. Looks like Castrodamas was right. York Adams is struggling. Mifflin wins big 56-7. And in the 4A bracket, an all-LL league showdown between 6-seed Lampeter Strasburg, 3-seed Northern Lebanon. Upset alert, LS comes from behind to win 34-19. Pioneers moving on.
I guess you can call that an upset. Finally, back to the 5A bracket. Overwhelming favorite here to win it all. Harrisburg Cougars, number one seed. They will take on Exeter Township Saturday afternoon at 1 o'clock.
And how about next week in the District 3 playoffs? We've got another classic on BRC 11. It'll be the Manheim Central Barons and Co-Calico Eagles renewing their rivalry for the second time this season. Barons knocked off the Eagles for their only loss this year. Think Co-Calico pay them back, or will Manheim book a return trip to those District 3 finals? Find out next Friday, 7 o'clock, right here on BRC 11 for our exclusive coverage of those District 3 semifinals.
Yeah, are we allowed to call that a revenge game maybe for Co-Calico?
Perhaps.
We will see. All right, we have seen all the scores, so let's check out our brackets. We've started here in 5A. Local teams advancing. Manheim Central over Waynesboro. Co-Calico over Cedar Crest. We saw the highlights for that. They will fill out the bottom half of the bracket. Love to see that showdown. And then at the top here, what do you think?
We could likely move Harrisburg over,
right, okay.
I would say.
Whatever, that's fine. All right, so let's move on to 6A. Let's see if we can get that back up here. In 6A, while we try to get that up for you.
The Township Wilson game.
Yeah, that's going to be amazing.
Should be incredible.
There you see it. Wilson Township going to meet for the second time this year.
It's hard to beat Wilson twice in a season.
Right, and then Cumberland Valley, Hempfield. We would think Cumberland Valley probably wins that, but again, that's going to be your other semifinal.
There's your visual aid.
All right, everybody, thanks so much for watching us all season long. And to our crew in the back, fantastic job. But we got to go. I'm Chad Landers.
And I'm Brian Cast. We'll see you next year.